What is going on, guys? Sam here, and welcome back to Samcraft, and welcome to another day in the life of this guy's 3D print business, I guess you could say, and something else I want to share. I've got another video for you guys today from my 3D print farm business, which is going to center around and be about filament. I want to show you a real life process of what it's like whenever I receive filament in, how I bring it into my business, prepare it for use, and put it into use. But I also want to talk about where I get filament from, why I purchase filament from that business, and my future plans, or at least testing on how that may change. All right, guys, this is a box that just got delivered, and as you're seeing it, is exactly how it arrives. This is filament from Bamboo Lab, and here lately, they've been getting a little bit slack on their shipments as far as quality. And I mean, what can we say, right? No one likes to see their product arrive like this. So anyone from Bamboo Lab, if you're watching this video, please take note. This is not a one-off thing. I order about, I would say probably 150 rolls of filament a month, at least at this point. And this has consistently become your new normal. So you can do better. Definitely do better. I just unpacked all the filament, and as you can see, this is pretty bad, right? So the quality of Bamboo has really gone downhill over the past 4 months as far as their shipment quality, how much care they put into your packaging, especially the filament orders. It's really gone downhill. I probably order about 150 rolls of filament from them every month. That's tending to go up and up as business increases and I expand my product lineup. And so to see this as a business owner, to see that I purchased this, but this is the kind of quality and care they put into shipping, consistently put into shipping, has me looking elsewhere. I'll talk about that towards the end of the video because I don't want to focus on that just yet. I want to continue to bring you guys along for my business process of bringing filament into my shop. All right, the first thing I do when I get my filament is I look at what I got and then I compare it with what I ordered. Some companies will give you packing slips. Bamboo Lab does not, so that's really annoying, especially whenever they split your order into two different shipments, three different shipments, or whatever they do, and you're just getting stuff kind of at random. Now, they do have the option to track your order on their website, so there is that option, but it would be nice if I actually got a paper packing slip in my order, just like I put in my own customer orders, so that the person knows they got what they ordered, or they know that what they have ordered is only being partially fulfilled. Either way, check the order, check the contents, and make sure things look good from there. After that, I go ahead and take my filament, and if I'm going to store it on my shelf, I will store it in the boxes. Actually, let's go take a look at that shelf real quick. All right, so over here in the corner of my shop, this is my 4 foot wide metal rolling shelf that currently houses all of my filament. Starting from the top, I've got two shelves full of more random colors, or it may seem random. These are all of the colors that I offer to my customers for custom colors on purchases. I keep them up here, and I always keep at least two full rolls or refills of that filament color. In addition to up here on the shelf, if we spin around on this middle island here, there are plastic totes underneath it, and that's where the open rolls of filament are stored. So presumably, if I'm staying on top of things, I'll have one open roll of all my colors and then two on the shelf here as backup. The reason I do that is so that I know when I go to this shelf and I pull off one color box, I need to order one color box. And that should give me 2 kilograms ready at all times to use in the event someone orders a particular color product and a lot of that product. This is at least my method and workflow in place right now with my current workload and order demands. As business grows, this will probably also grow. But for the time being, 2 filaments on the shelf, 1 in the box, seems to be pretty good. So I took a second to look and I actually lied to you guys. I have 3 shelves full of random colors and then below it, 3 shelves of solid colors, or at least more solid color storage. Okay, so what am I getting at? Half of my shelf is for custom colors. The bottom half are for the three primary colors that my product lineups are sold as. You will see that I have blue, green, and white filament. Of those three, the green is the most popular, and it is the one that I keep on hand the most. I like to try and keep at least 26 rolls of green on here. That gives me one refill per printer and hopefully gives me above the curve. Again, as my business changes, my workflow changes, I may up that minimum quantity to a higher number. Through the holiday season, I will deviate from that, and that is I keep about 45 to 50 kilograms of the color on hand, because when you get into the Black Friday season, your holiday shopping season, stresses get put on those shipping avenues, order fulfillment processes, whatever you want to call it, and I don't want to be left here with no filament to make my products from. So this time of year, right now it is December, I have a lot of filament here and I have filament elsewhere stored because this is my time to bulk up and save up, just in case. So that being said, I'm going to bring the cases that we just bought and I've unpacked over there on the table over here and stick them on the shelf. Then I want to turn my attention to show you guys what I now do as far as preparing filament for use, because I don't just take it directly out of the box and load it up onto my 3D printers. All right, so now it's time to get some filament off of my shelf. We get our boxes. We're gonna go ahead and open it and prepare it for the next step, which is to remove it from the package. This is a refill, so there's no spool included. I need to get an empty spool, mount this on there, and then I'm gonna show you guys the dehydrator, which is the new addition to my shop, a relative new workflow addition, but one that has become just part of my flow and would be something that I would probably also recommend to you, at least if you're doing this from a business standpoint. This is now ready to be used, or in my case, dried. That's right, Sam said dry filament. So if you follow my channel, you will know I've had some adventures in trying to figure out filament and troubleshooting things. Had an event happen in my workshop which caused a very humid environment and led me to implement a dehumidifier in the shop, some relative humidity hygrometers around the shop to keep track on those levels. I've also got air quality meters now, which is going to tie into a future video talking about VOCs, or the potential of, and 3D printing. But basically, been chasing this rabbit trail of humidity and how much does it affect my outcome, what is causing outcomes, whether it be good or bad, and just making sure I get the top quality finished product to my customers, no matter what it takes. Along this journey, I purchased a commercial size food dehydrator. I chose a dehydrator for drying my filament because I could put as much filament in it as possible, much more than any kind of filament dryers out there on the market that were still relatively low priced. This dehydrator is nothing special. I purchased it from Amazon, and I purchased it not because of the name brand, but because of the features, the size, and the overall build quality. I'll put a link to this one down below if you are interested, but again, just know it's not a name brand that I am sponsored with. They've not endorsed me. I purchased it with my own money, but I've been using it for about a month and a half now, and I'm really happy with it. Some cool features about the dehydrator that I like is that it is all stainless steel construction. There is a grate on the very back inside, which keeps me from pushing filament up against the heating element or the fan. So it has a great safety feature from that standpoint. It will hold a ton of filament like you're about to see, and it also has digital temperature and timer controls. This dehydrator I can set to run however long I like. In my particular case, I dry my PLA filament at 50 degrees Celsius for 12 hours. So that means I just simply punch it in on the top of the machine, it turns on, and at that 12 hour point, it automatically turns off. That is fantastic. That is a great convenience and something that allows me to start the drying process during the day, knowing that it will finish at night, but automatically turn off and be ready the next business day. One last thing I will say, whether or not to dry your filament is a heavily debated topic among 3D print enthusiasts. So you're going to see schools of thought, people saying yes, people saying no, comments on this video surely saying yes and no. So my advice to you is to test it out, see if you think you need it, or if you don't want to bother with that, just dry it to begin with. If your filament is dry, you can always ignore that advice from online forums when people randomly and always tell you, dry your filament, because you will know I did dry it. That is not my particular issue. Then you can advance to the next level. All right, that being said, let's go ahead and unload this guy first because last night's batch is done, and let's reload it so we can stay ahead of our production curves to make sure we are always ready with fresh, dry filament. All right, guys, we're gonna open the latch here on the right-hand side. You got this wide door, which opens up 180 degrees. And first thing I'm gonna do, just unload the filament. So as I do that, I'm gonna stick it over here to my shelf to the left side of the dehydrator. This is where I've been staging my dry filament for now. But as production is building up, I need to find a better solution, probably another roll around shelf or something like that, to store the dried filament and to keep it nice and clean, maybe free from dust. So maybe it'd be worthwhile to put it in some boxes, but basically not put it here at this center table work area, because this is a very handy spot for offloading printers and doing other printer-based filament work that I don't want to have just tied up for filament storage. So that being said, you may think, okay, Sam, cool, you dried your filament, but you just stuck it on a shelf in your shop. Isn't that going to undry your filament, or aren't you going to have issues with that? I would say yes, unless you're running like me. I have a dehumidifier over there plumbed up to my sink drain, so it runs 24/7. It is at a set percentage that it automatically turns on and off, and it keeps my shop's relative humidity very low. Right now, this is reading 26% relative humidity with a 24-hour range of 20% low, 26% high. So right now, 26% relative humidity is the most humid my shop's been in the last 24 hours. So from that standpoint, I feel fine storing these spools in my open air because I'm in a climate-controlled shop with a dehumidifier running 24/7. If you're not in such an area, or if you're doing this inside your home, you're gonna want more humidity in your air. By the way, first of all, this kind of environment's very dry for the skin, and it's fine because it's a separate work area. So if you're in your house, lock it up, box it up. If you're in a shop like me, and this is really a production environment where human comfort comes last, then it should be good open air storage. What I now want to do is go ahead and load up the dehydrator, get it going on its next batch of filament, so I can again stay ahead of my curve. What you're actually going to see is this load of filament that I just removed being loaded on just from a couple of days ago. I started this video then, had some technical issues, and now I'm finishing it out today. Overall, the process is the same, but you'll notice a little bit of difference here and there, and that's because you're about to go back in time to see this filament that I just took out be loaded in to then come back to the future or the present to finish out the video. Wow, let's get confused, right? Either way, roll that beautiful bean footage. Got you set up here so you can see me load the stuff in. So let's count them as we go, right? 3, 4, 5, and you wouldn't think it, 6 fits in there. Look at that. Could I have asked for a better fit? Probably not. All right, this guy's going all the way to the back and the left side. Again, that metal grate back there makes it wonderful. I know I can just push these back till they stop, and I'm not going to touch the element or cause any problems. So now we can go ahead and take our next stack. Goes right there. 2 more, that makes 5 on that side. And 1 more up top, 6. Good to go. And we'll take this stack. Now it won't fit like that until you pick the lip up. But now I got that guy right there. And we'll take the rest of this stack. And I'm just a couple short from a full load, so I'll go ahead and take the very top ones down. So the last thing I do before I close this guy up is I get one of my portable hygrometers or humidity monitor with temperature, set it right here up front. Right now it's sitting at 25% humidity. I'll go ahead and close it up here, latch the side over here, and we're done. Now we go to the top, press some buttons, and we'll start this guy. All right, guys, so we'll go ahead and turn this guy on. Temperature, you set here, you can go up and down. 50 degrees Celsius is where I leave it at. Set my timer, 12 hours. Go ahead and leave it. And once it goes solid, it is on. And now this guy is running. One of the great things about this is that it is super quiet. You probably can't tell it as much because of 3D printers fans running over there in the background, and you can probably hear that, if anything, but this guy is super quiet. It also doesn't get super hot to the touch running at 50 degrees Celsius, so I don't have any problems with things around it like they are, but I definitely don't leave anything sitting here. So there you have it, guys. There's my process on bringing filament into the shop, where I store it, how I store it, the quantities or variations that I do keep on hand. Again, that's completely dependent upon your product line, so don't take my example to be the universal example. But then also how I bring it over to my dehydrator for drying, preparing it for being used, and right now where it sits until it is put onto the printers. When all the printers are running full bore in 24 hours, they will consume about 12 to 13 kilograms of filament. Now, of course, that's going to vary depending upon the print jobs. So it's not like I have 12 to 13 green rolls every single day, but that is the amount of filament that can run through the 26 printers here. I guess that equates to what? Half a kilogram per printer per day? So there you go. If you run your printer nonstop, okay, at least in my case, that's how much I go through. So from that standpoint, honestly, I need to make sure I dry 12 to 13 rolls every single day. And I've been pretty good at doing that. Now at the same time, I am currently at the good printer level to meet my current workflow demands and business demands. But if business demands drop off, obviously I won't dry as much filament. Or if they pick up, well, I guess I won't dry a whole lot more filament, will I? Because you can only use what you can use, but it definitely will have me growing and scaling as need be. However, that's going to get into a whole other conversation about business growth and scaling, which if you follow my channel, you'll know I've scaled this pretty quickly, but I want that to be a dedicated content. The last thing I want to mention in this video is that I did say at the beginning that I've been buying my filament from Bamboo Lab, at least up until this point. I have been researching other companies based upon their prices, their quality, and their availabilities, and I've placed one order as a test the waters type thing. Should get that shipment in hopefully this upcoming week, and I look forward to trying out this other company's filament and then looking more into, honestly, can they meet my demand? I don't feel like my business is yet to the point where I'm going to be purchasing filament bulk by the hundreds or thousands of rolls and importing them myself from overseas manufacturers. So that puts me in the boat of purchasing filament from commercial sources that most of you out there will also use, but also in the boat that I need reliable, reputable companies to not be out of stock a lot and to keep their color codes and their color of their filament as close to dead on as possible from batch to batch. So far that's been Bamboo Lab, and I've not had any problems with either one of those. My only complaint so far at Bamboo Lab has been their shipping has been ugh lately, the quality of shipping. Other than that, their prices are just about the cheapest you can get, especially when you take into account the other two factors of not being out of stock on me at random times and keeping their colors matching from lot to lot. All right, that's going to be it for this filament video. I'm sure I've yakked on long enough. If you've got questions or comments, leave them for me down below. If there's something in this that you were hoping I would cover that I did not, leave me a comment. And if there are videos along 3D print or business related as well that you want to know, give me the comment there as well. A lot of my inspiration for what I create on this channel comes from you, so it's great, and it'll only help you in the long run if you let me know what you want to see. Otherwise, take care as always, and I'll see you guys next time in the workshop.